What's up, everybody? Happy Father's Day. Sitting here sipping my coffee in my Hello Kitty mug. So I wanted to show that I can take U11 off of a Hi-Def NES and then reinstall it to show that that 3.3 volt regulator can be replaced so that we can fix some of these Hi-Def NES kits that have that issue. So I'll go ahead and power this on just so that I can show this is working. There you go. Mario will start moving here in just a second. You see that coin moving, so there's no problems going on here. All right. So let's go ahead and get that regulator removed and then reattach it.
Who put this thing together? Me! That's who! Who do I trust? Me!
Okay, so this is U11, which is that 3.3 volt regulator. So I've just taped off all the components around here because I'm thinking I'm having issues with the heat when I go to take this off. I'm actually frying these cheap chips. So I'm gonna come at this with a little more tact. So I'll get it all taped off. I'm gonna come in here with some low heat and just slowly crank it up until I get that off. Ooh, here we go. Okay, so there we go, we got the voltage regulator removed. Had a look around everywhere for my flux. Let's see. Drop some in. Get some wick. Clean up these pads a little. See if I can get y'all a better shot here. Got a glare going on. Alright, here she is. Put it back on. Little heavy with the solder paste. All But honestly, I can probably work with it the way it is. Here we go. Off a little. Maybe that was kept in tape on here. No components stuck to it, so that's good. So, I'm sure y'all saw this big solder blob. So this chip has three legs on this side, three legs on this side. So obviously all three of those are grounded together. So let's see here. Used a little too much solder paste, which I don't have a whole lot of experience using that. A little bit of flux, and then come in here with my soldering iron. Okay, I got most of it already. I'm gonna come back one more time. Clean it up. Okay, now I want to check and make sure that none of those other pins are attached to ground. The only pin that is tied to ground is the middle one on this side right here. All the others we should not be have continuity to ground. So let me get this set up here. If anybody knows of a good multimeter that has like real fine points on it for doing stuff like this, because this is a pain in the ass. I end up using a alligator clip and then just holding a component leg with it to give me a nice fine point. So there we go, get that attached to ground. Make sure. Alright, so like I said, this middle one here should have contact. There we go. This left one, nada. Right one, nada. Let's check the other side. That'll be kind of fun to do with the camera. This is the side that had the big old blob.
If I can change.
Nothing. Nothing.
And you can change.
Вы можете измениться.
Everybody can change!
Looking for my loot so I can get y'all a better old game tech trick here. There you go. There it is. Alright, so let's test it. Power this time. go, moment of truth. We got power, we got light, and booyah! So I'm not sure why the thought was that this can't be replaced, because it can. I just need that part number. If I get that part number, I can fix these that have that 3.3 volt regulator. Problem is I already tried doing that on two others that I had here just so I could prove it, but I think I was coming at it too hot, and those cheap regulators just can't take the heat. So it's popping them when I'm trying to take them off. So if I can get a good replacement for that, man, that would be nice. Still going. Anyways, like I said, happy Father's Day, guys.
Latest.